standard, and out of this benefit, I told you we will be discussing only short-term benefits, right? What are the
100 minus 20? It is 80% now. 8 rupees. Very simple. Get the answer directly rather than going through those things.
Some phrases such as binding in honor only. Binding in honor only වගේ phrase එකක් දැම්මට පස්සේ that implies that the intention to be legally binding is not there. Okay, when we start planning, we are going to take all these things into one place and we are going to see what are the ways and how it's going to impact on our business. That is first one, environmental scanning. The business sends this money to a fund. It may be the EPF fund. So in that case, EPF funds invest, and whatever the interest that they accrue depending on the losses or gain, based on the funds that they avail. Because why employer has the investment risk? Because the fund value, because the benefit is not fixed. So benefit is depending on the benefit that you get will be depending on the quality of your investment. So if your investment earning higher return, the value of the fund will go high, the amount you will be getting will be also much higher. But in case if your investment make losses, then
percentage change is calculated like this. New value minus original value divide by original value into 100. Very easy. What is the new value now? 340 minus 490 divide by 490 into 100. Now you know that we can't subtract 490 from 340. Okay. So what we are taking is, we are taking the difference of the two values. Okay. Difference means you can subtract the smallest one from the largest one. Difference. So from here onward,
parties of the case. This is the person who filed the case. This is the person against whom the case was filed. V means versus, but if it is that much we know, we write it as VS. But in the legal context, we only write the letter V, not VS both. Okay? So you read Balfour versus Balfour and Merit versus Merit. දෙන්නට එකම නම් තියනවා කියන්නේ මොකද්ද වෙලා තියෙන්නේ? These cases between the husband and the wife. For example, the husband went abroad and he agreed to his wife that he will send a definite amount of money to his wife every month, right? Later they entered into a quarrel and the husband didn't send money anymore. The wife filed action saying that my husband agreed to send me money but he is not sending anymore. Then the court held that you are husband and wife, therefore your agreement is a domestic agreement, therefore it is not legally enforceable, so you can't force him to send money. Okay, so that is
for an example. I need to get past my exam, that's my goal, but I need to get a 75 plus mark for business management in this year exam. That is a smart objective. So you have to be always specific and measurable and quantifiable in terms of the numbers, and that is called an objective. So let me just say, our main exports are what? Apparels, or else tourism, or else tea or gem. So let's say tea is
and withdrawers.
Having said that, so the where the place where these two people get interact is called a financial market. So now in a nutshell, what do you need to know in terms of financial market?